अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द डिवीजन ओओमाइकोटा एंड द जीनस ऑफ दिस ओओमाइकोटा पाइथियम। सो फर्स्टली वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस अबाउट द जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड व्हाई इट इज नोन एज ओओमाइकोटा। एक्चुअली इट इज अ डिवीजन ऑफ फंजाई एंड इट produce many large sized reproductive structures called oogonia. So due to production of these oogonia, this is named as oomycota. So when we talk about this oogonia, then large number of oogonia, large size of oogonia are produced. So that's why it is given to the name oomycota. So when we talk about the gametes, which are produced in the members of the oomycota, these are of two types. Firstly, the large sized gametes are produced in a structure, and structure is called oogonia. So due to presence of large oogonia, this is named as oomycota. And the second type of gametes are actually known as sperms, and these are produced in the male sex structures, and male sex structures in the oomycota are known as antheridia. So actually, when we talk about the sperms, these are small sized, but when we talk about the eggs, which are produced in these oogonia, are larger in size. It means eggs are larger in size, but sperms are smaller in size. So now we are going to discuss some other structures. Actually, the fungi belong to this division are filamentous. These are parasites of plants. These are also present on the decaying plants. They are heterotrophic, and these are absorptive in nature. These are absorptive in nature. So now we'll try to discuss about the classification of a genus which is actually belong to this division, which is known as Oomycota. So now we will try to discuss about the classification. In the classification, we start from the division and we will end to the genus. So firstly, we will try division, class, order, family, and genus. So firstly, we'll try to discuss about the division. Actually, division is oomycota. So division is oomycota. Class is oomycetes. Order is Pyronosporales. Family is Pythiaceae or Pythiaceae, and the genus is Pythium. Genus is Pythium. So now we will try to discuss about this genus, which is known as Pythium. So Firstly, we'll try to discuss about the occurrence of pygium. Occurrence of pygium. Actually, this is also present in the soil. It is present in the soil water. It is present in soil water. These are present on the dead decaying plants. Dead decaying plants. So due to presence of dead decaying plants, so we can write here, these are saprophytes. These are saprophytes. They also live on the living plants. They also live on living plants. Actually, they attack to the plants, but especially they attack on the roots as well as seedlings. They attack on roots of plants as well as seedlings. Roots of plants and seedlings. They cause the disease in plants, and the disease name is damping off disease. Disease name is damping off disease. Actually, this disease is caused by a species of Pythium, which is known as Pythium debaryonym. Pythium debaryonym. Actually, this is a species of the genus Pythium, which causes the disease in the plants, which is known as damping off disease. So now we are going to discuss about the general characteristics of the Pythium. So when we talk about the general characteristics, then we can say that mycelium. What is mycelium? Actually, the body of fungi is known as mycelium. So when we talk about the mycelium, then we can say that mycelium is sinusoidal. Mycelium is sinusoidal. Sinusoidal means there are no cross walls. So sinusoidal, what means sinusoidal? For example, this one is a filament of a fungi, and these are the nuclei present in the fungi. If there are cross walls between the nuclei, then we can say that this is a non-sinusoidal. Then if these separations or cross walls are not present, then we can say that the body of mycelium is sinusoidal, also known as unsepted. Branched, it means the mycelium or a body of this fungi, which is known as Pythium, is branched. These are filamentous. Filamentous, it means filaments are also present in the body of this genus, which is known as Pythium. Then, when we talk about the cell wall of this fungi, it's an interesting point that we have studied that the cell wall of fungi is composed of chitin, but there is an exception in the case of this Pythium. The cell wall of fungi is composed of cellulose. Actually, it is an important component in the plant cell wall, but the fungal cell wall, this type of fungi having a cell wall which is composed of cellulose. So we can write here, cell wall is composed of cellulose. But the plant body or a protoplast of this fungi, which is known as Pythium, contain, so we can write here, protoplast of this fungi also contain glycogen droplets, they contain the glycogen droplets or drops inside the protoplast of the cell. So when we talk about the parasitic nature of this fungi, which is known as Pythium, then they are intracellular parasite and also extracellular parasites or intercellular. So two types of parasites are present in this. Number one type of parasite is known as intracellular parasites, and the second type of parasites which are present in this, it means these are both type of parasite, intracellular as well as intercellular parasites. So now we will try to differentiate what are the meanings or what are the difference between the intracellular as well as intercellular parasites. So when we try to understand the difference between intracellular and intercellular, so we have to make a diagram on the whiteboard to understand better. For example, these are the cells of the host tissue. For example, these are the cells of host tissue. If the fungi grow inside the tissue but outside the cells, now this is the red color I am drawing, is actually the fungi, but it is present between the cells, not it is penetrating inside the cell. So this is actually a fungi, but no filament of the fungi is penetrating inside the cell. Actually, it is present between the cells. So the fungi which are acting as a parasite of this tissue, but it is present outside the cells or between the cells, such type of parasites are known as intercellular. It means intercellular means between the cells, not inside the cells. So this type of fungi which is acting as a parasite, so it is intercellular parasite. So we can write here, this is intercellular parasitic mode of nutrition. So now we'll try to discuss about how it acts as intracellular. So for example, these are the cells of the plant tissue, and this one is a fungi. This one is a fungi, but now it is trying to affect all these cells. But this fungi will penetrate inside the cell, not between the cells. When the fungi infect the cell and penetrate inside the cell, then this, now we can see here, this fungi is growing to throughout the inside of the cell. It means this is passing inside the cell. When the fungi, parasitic fungi, grow inside the cell like this, so we can say that this type of fungi is known as intracellular parasite. So we can write here, this one is intracellular parasite. Now we are trying to discuss about the disease cycle of Pythium in the plant. So we can write here, disease cycle. Actually, this type of fungi, which is actually a parasite of plant, it penetrates into the plants with the help of small openings of the plants which are present in the leaves, which are known as stomata. So for example, this one is a leaf of plant, so definitely we know that this plant contains small pores, and these small pores are used for the gaseous exchange as well as evaporation and the transpiration. So these are the pores which are present in the leaves. So this fungi actually enter from outside to inside the plant through these small pores, and these small pores are known as stomata. It means this fungi is penetrating in the plants through the stomata. Now this fungi grow towards the plant portion. Actually, this is a plant and this is epidermal portion. Epidermal portion of the plant. And this one is the central portion, and always the central portion of the plant contains the vascular bundles, and these are known as vascular bundles. And we know that in the vascular bundle, xylem and phloem are present. Xylem and phloem are present. It means vascular bundles are actually xylem and phloem. So this fungi penetrate in the plant through these small pores of the plant which are present in the leaves and grow towards the cortical cells. But keep in mind, outside to this vascular bundle there is a large portion or a broader portion in the plants, and this portion is known as cortical region or a cortex. This portion in the plants is known as cortex. This one is a cortical region, and the cells which are present in this region are known as cortical cells. Cortical cells. So firstly, which move from the stomata, it infect these cells, and these cells are known as cortical cells. When these cortical cells are infected, actually it weaken these portion, and this plant will damp off or a fall. So how it will fall, we will try to discuss about a small diagram. For example, this one is a plant, this one is a plant. This fungi effect on this portion or a central or a stem portion of the plant and infect the central portion. When this central portion become weak, actually this become like this. It means now it is bowing or falling, and at the last this will fall on the ground. But when they are fall, then this fungi move from cortical region to this central portion which is known as vascular bundle, and spread in all over the body of the plant, and now the plant body is dead. Then this fungi, which is known as Pythium, actually try to decompose and release many more enzyme to digest the plant material and absorb it. So it was mode of nutrition as a disease cycle. And actually this disease which is actually infected, this plant is infected by this disease, and this disease is known as damping of disease. And this damping of disease is caused by the Pythium, and the species of the Pythium is known as Pythium debrayensis.